The tubing kit must be replaced every 6 months for optimal performance of this instrument. Replacement of the tubing kit can be difficult. Please use the following procedure to simplify this process. Empty the waste container of any fluids from primes or stain procedures. Remove the three reagent cannulas from the reagent bottles and place them into the empty waste container. Press F1 twice to run two prime cycles while the cannulas are in the waste container. This will purge any residual fluid that may be in the old cannulas. Now power off the instrument. Remove the front panel. Stretch the old orange pump tubes off of the rollers. Next, remove the pump tubes from the brackets. Using a hemostat or forceps, pull the clear cannula line straight down from where they are connected to the base of the cuvette chamber. Cut the zip ties that hold the clear cannula lines in place, and completely remove the tube kit from the machine. Get your new tubing kit and replace the tube sets one at a time, starting from left to right. The longest cannula lines are to be positioned on the left side of the orange pump tubes, and the shorter cannula lines should be on the right side of the pump tubes. Pull the shorter clear tube of each of the cannula lines through the hole below the cuvette chamber, and connect the tube to the correct metal port at the base of the cuvette. From left to right, pump number 1 rinse, pump number 2 buffer, pump number 3 waste, and pump number 4 stain. Refer to the IFU for images of which labeled cannula line goes to which pump. There are numbers below the metal connectors that will clarify which pump roller it is responsible for. Take the long end of the clear cannula tube and wrap it around the right side of the machine. Make sure the cannula elbows are tightly connected to the orange pump tubes. Put the waste cannula into the waste container and the reagent cannulas into DI water. Run two prime cycles to confirm that the tubing and cannula lines are correctly installed. Watch the cannula lines by the metal port to verify that water is being brought up in the correct stain schematic. Once the cannula lines are correctly installed, apply zip ties to the indicated places on the machine. This will ensure that the lines stay out of the way and can be contained neatly under the front panel. Now replace the front panel. After every tube replacement, the fill levels for the stain procedure must be reset. See the Set Fill Level video for instructions.